All right, day 35, on the move. It's almost 9 o'clock, and I'm leaving the Super 8, nice and light. But I should still be able to do the 18 miles a day, especially if there's a shelter on the B&O that I want to get to. So, yep, that's the plan. And yeah, let's get started. I'm ready to hike. My ankle still feels a little sore, but I'll be really favoring it all day today. But it does feel a lot better than it was before. So it's good to know that it's not something, well, permanent, hopefully. All right. What day is it? Yeah, today's the 18th. And yeah, 18th of March, and let's get going. All right, later. All right, just got to the top of the last, what I hope it is, the last decently hard hill of West Virginia. So, should be downhill, flattish to the B&O from here. Yeah, my ankle feels okay-ish. I'm exaggerating my limp so I don't push off on it at all, so I am going slower, but it's not actively hurting, so that's good. As I just crested this hill, yeah, ready to get going right there. All right, leaving Adamston. I think it's the last in a string of cities. Well, not really cities, towns that are all strung together. Now I'll be following the 50, not exactly on it, but along the side roads, and that's where the B&O goes along too. So, yeah, it's fun. It's actually decently cold right now. Yeah, it's not, and I'm gonna break over 40 degrees today, so. Got my jacket, gloves, and hat on. And it's gonna get into the 20s tonight, so that should be fun. But yeah, I like it cold. It's better than warm, better than sweating. So, yeah, see you guys. So I think I'm on what will become part of the B&O rail trail. Because it's not the official trail, it's actually right to the left of it. Official trail's on the road, but this is a little bit better. Because even though it's unmaintained, it doesn't have cars on it, so. But there's freeways this way, actual trails this way, so I don't know if I go the wrong way. But yeah, Sharon, the West Virginia coordinator, told me that they're going to be extending the B&O, and I'm pretty sure. Well, it should be easy to just go right through here. It's already all graded and everything. All they have to do is just put in more gravel. Okay. I got about 9 more miles to go on the day. It's 1 o'clock, so I have plenty of time. So. Yeah, my ankle is actually feeling better. As you walk on it, injury like that, sometimes it just starts feeling better as the muscles get moving and the blood starts flowing and the nerves start to deaden. So yeah, all the good things. All right, later. Alright, just got past the 50, you actually follow the trail. The trail follows it for about a mile, so 50, so freeway, four lane highway. Starting to snow, which wasn't supposed to happen, but shows you how decently cold it is right now. I don't know if you can see it or not. I'm almost to B&O. So that's the good news. and I should be off-road walking for a while. Now, once I get there. All right. Yeah, I showed you guys that when we do get there. All right, this is what I'm talking about. The B&O Real Trail. Still right next to the freeway, but not on it, so that's cool. Don't have to worry about being run over, which is also cool, and it's, you see, relatively flat, which is very cool. I only got about 3.5 more miles a day to get to this shelter. Then after that, I think I'm going to stay at Sharon's place again, because that's where I was supposed to usually get, stay with her when I get that close. She very nicely, 3 or 4 days ago, it's 4 or 5 now, 5 days ago, drove out to get me, when I didn't realize how far away I actually was. So that helped. But now, I get to stay there again. Well, that'll be tomorrow. It's another 16 miles to where she's at. Alright. But I'm happy. I'm on the rail trail. And I'm hoping more of the hike is like this. Reported my ankle. Feels okay. Especially compared to like 3 days ago. And I've been hobbling all day just to make sure I don't push off on it as much as I normally do. So I try to keep it less damaged. But yeah, it's just something I'll have to deal with it from now on. And hopefully the 2 days rest was enough to break the cycle of it getting worse every day. All right, later. I believe this is the first of many tunnels that I'm going to have to walk through. Yeah, this is a much better way to go over a hill. Let's go through it. Yeah. I like it. Hopefully it doesn't drip on me too much, though. It is getting cold. It's getting colder and, glad I'm going to be in a shelter. Well, I want to see if the shelter is an actual shelter. I haven't really seen a picture of it, so. There is snow flurrying every once in a while, just not sticking to the ground. But, yep. There's the first of many tunnels. All right, later. In the middle of the tunnel. Well, not really. Maybe a quarter of the way through. But it's something different. Blue. Oh! Yeah. I like it. Nice and cold in here, though. So, I'm gonna keep on moving. Alright, later. Yeah, so I got here to where the shelter's supposed to be. There's no shelter. Just the bathroom, which is good enough for me. So, I want to camp right over here. What's good about this spot is that, there's some sort of water treatment plant over here or something. And it's outflows right over here. So, be a lot of good white noise over here to drown out all the traffic that's going to probably be coming by. So, this will make it easy to sleep. All right. But, yeah, it's gonna be cold tonight, so I'm gonna bundle up. All right, later.